engine technology obviously continues to get more and more advanced, and this requires more and more from an aftermarket standalone ECU in order to keep up. I'm here with Dan from Link Engine Management to talk about their newly released G5 platform. For a start, before we jump into this new platform, Dan, we've been running on the G4, then the G4 Plus, and then the G4X for a number of years. It's a platform that I know very well, and we've used it for a lot of our worked examples and our course material. What drove the requirements to go to this new G5 platform? Where were the limitations coming in on the G4X?
Well, there wasn't so much limitations around the tuning or the performance of the G4X. It's a great platform and we're still going to provide support and run that into the future. G5 has come about because of the need for direct injection capable. So with the addition of a driver box, the new G5 Voodoo is able to control direct injection ECUs as well.
Okay, so it won't control the injectors directly. You can't wire straight from the G5 Voodoo to a direct injector. It does need an interface box. And a lot of OE manufacturers actually go down this path anyway, such as, for example, the Toyota 86 is a classic.
Absolutely, yeah. So we will be developing one, and there's a few aftermarket ones out there that do the job as well, yeah.
Okay, so you say you'll be developing one, so this will be to support direct injected engines where the OE manufacturer doesn't use an interface box?
Yeah, it's something that, you know, when you go online, you can buy both products from us, and then you know that they're matched really well, and then they'll be able to control the engine.
With the development of direct injected engines, I mean, these are obviously not new by any stretch of the imagination now. I've sort of seen initially a drive by a lot of ECU manufacturers to support DI engines, and certainly there is some demand there, but I've also seen that as power levels climbed, a lot of people kind of quickly realized that, you know, you couldn't get larger direct injectors and they were running out of fuel. A lot of people actually ended up switching back to port injectors or alternatively adding port injectors to supplement the DI side of things. So, in terms of that, do you have the ability to have both port and DI on the G5?
Yeah, absolutely. So we can have purely DI, or we can run a port injection and a DI injection as well, just to really get that power level up if people want to.
So on that front, like how many injector drives, how many injector outputs have we got on the G5 Voodoo?
So this one is, I believe, 16. So it's 12 cylinder sequential it will run, or we can run a stage injection, whether that's DI or whether it's port stage injection as well.
So on that front, if you are going to be interfacing with a separate box for a direct injected engine, it isn't a CAN bus control or a bespoke control to that box. You're actually wiring your injector drives to that box?
To that box, yes, I believe so, yeah. Yeah.
Let's talk about some of the other changes with the G5 platform. And one of the obvious ones is the look of it. It's now moved to a billet CNC machine enclosure.
Yeah, that mainly, obviously, the look and feel, you know, it looked and feels great. And it also allows us to provide sealing around the unit as well, you know. So they're fully sealed, so it should help with any environmental issues.
So potentially something that could be mounted safely in the engine bay as opposed to in the cabin?
Yes, I believe so, yep.
GPS, this is another new addition to the G5, so talk us through that.
So yeah, so we've added GPS as well. So this, I believe, is 50 times GPS on here. So
50 hertz.
50 hertz, yeah. So it will be able to give you track position, time and date, and all of that kind of stuff as well. So there'll be an antenna, like a puck antenna, that's provided in the box. So then you'll be able to work out all your track position and use GPS.
Okay. So lots of advantages with having that on board as opposed to relying on an external module there. Obviously, yeah. A cost saving, not needing to buy that additional module. The other elements that I'm interested in here, drive-by-wire and closed loop or wideband control, I should say.
Yeah. So there's dual wideband controller and there's also dual e-throttle controllers on the ECU built in. So
again, in terms of the wideband control, a lot of ECUs have gone down the path of requiring an external CAN-based module. This is all on board, no additional costs there.
Exactly, yeah. So you just wire your wideband sensors directly into the ECU.
In terms of the user interface and the user experience, I mean, users coming from the existing G4, G4 Plus, G4X platform, we've had a pretty consistent look and feel to that user interface. What are we going to be working with on the G5?
The G5 software is going to be exactly the same. So we're really wanted to keep the interface the same. So people that know G4X and G4 Plus, when they move into G5, they're very familiar with it. So the maps will be able to go from a G4X into G5. And then you can, rather than having to retune and reconfigure, it's all there. So it will work straight away.
Now, one of the more interesting elements with this G5 platform that I spotted is the CAN bus side of things. So a little bit more advanced, and I know probably not all tuners are going to take advantage of this, but I've really liked the Link platform because all along the way, the CAN bus has probably been one of the most user configurable out there of all of the ECUs that I tune. So you've got a lot of flexibility. If you are capable of writing your own CAN templates, you can receive information from other brands' products, you can transmit out to other brands' products and dashes really, really easily. Particularly when it comes to integrating with some of the more modern cars, there's a lot of CAN bus devices in the cars, and tuners can go to the through the process and take the time and effort to develop their own CAN bus template, but then you don't really want to necessarily give all that information away for free if you're a tuner selling your product. So you can actually protect your IP on the G5, correct?
Yeah, you can. So as you said, you know, Link's historically been very open source with the CAN bus and really, you know, user-friendly, so you can write any kind of streams you like. But with the G5, we've actually got a feature in there where you can lock the CAN bus down separate to the actual full base map. So all the CAN information is encrypted. So if you don't want anyone to look in there, you know, your IP, then you can do that.
So essentially, if you're a tuning workshop and you've spent a couple of days reverse engineering the CAN messaging to maybe a factory dashboard so that the G5 will work seamlessly with the factory dashboard, displaying speed, coolant temperature, RPM and all of that, you can then sell that package to customers but lock down that CAN bus so that other people don't benefit from your IP.
Yes, exactly. Yeah.
All right, so this product is relatively new. Is it actually available for public consumption yet, or if not, how close to release is it?
We'll be shipping from New Zealand this week into the regions. So then it will be probably next week to the week after that we'll be shipping from the regions out to our dealer network.
Okay, and if people do want to find out more, get in touch with a local Link dealer and buy the product, how are they best to do so?
So jump on the website, linkecu.com. On there, you can find a dealer. You've got heaps of information about the G5 on there. And yeah, there you go.
All right, thanks for your time, Dan.
You're welcome. Cheers.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.